and now it was not only to be filled with God's Spirit, to be full of God's Spirit. It was not only to be led by God's Spirit, but we must have love. Without love, we can't go anywhere. Without love, we can't reach anybody. We talk and we pray till thy kingdom come, but if we have no love, there's nowhere we can reach. But Jesus Christ, being full of the Holy Ghost, was willing to be led. He submitted himself to the leading of the Spirit of God. His first assignment was a taste. Let me hear what he said, just a taste. Amen. How many of us today are ready to be tested and tried by the Almighty? How many of us are ready to be led by the Holy Spirit? How many of us are ready to obey the Spirit of God? In order for the church to be ready to change life, it must be ready to represent. Let me hear somebody say represent.
Represent.
Represent. And if we look in verses 3 to 4, the first test that the church, that the church must face individually and collectively, is its readiness to represent. Jesus, in his state of hunger, he had not eaten anything for 40 days and 40 nights. He was on a compulsory, absolute fast. He was full of the Spirit, yes, yet empty of food, bodily nourishment. But what an opportune time for the tempter to approach and take note of the tempter's ploy. Yes. This is what the devil said to him: if you are the Son of God, yes, tell these stones to become bread. Tell these stones to become bread. It's not that the devil never knew who Jesus was, yes, but he said if. The if clause shows that a fact is missing, or there is some sort of probability, or there is some sort of doubt. But there was no doubt in the devil's mind who he was. In Mark 5:7, when Jesus and the disciples crossed over to the country of the Gadarenes, the demon met him and he said to Jesus, "What do you want with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God?" So the devil knows who we are. The devil knows who you are, and he will seek for opportune time to come and accuse and tempt you. It was Jesus' time, and the devil was using a ploy to get Jesus to lose focus from his human state. The devil knew that he was hungry. He knew he was the Son of God, and if the Son of God, he had powers to his disposal that would easily turn stones into bread. Jesus, being full of the Holy Ghost, was not here for himself. He was Emmanuel. What does Emmanuel mean? God with us. Here was the incarnate of God, Jesus the Christ, on his earthly sojourn, and he was now about to represent all of mankind. He had taken on right here in the wilderness during the 40 days of fasting and prayer a state of hunger that mankind had ever experienced, a state of hunger that mankind is experiencing, and a state of hunger that mankind would experience. He took this on to himself right there in the desert. But I love how Jesus responded to the tempter. He said, "It is written." He never said, he never said Jesus Christ or the Son of God does not live on bread alone. Because it was not about himself. He spoke to the tempter, the enemy, and he said, "Man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God." The devil referred to him as the Son of God. But Jesus' response called before the strength of man when he's full of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Even in his state of hunger, surrounded by thistles and thorns, the sun baking his skin, he was standing looking up for humanity and its frailties and failures. Jesus Christ stood up for you and I. 40 days and 40 nights. My brothers and sisters, it was something that Christ had within him that we only read about, that we only get to fight the battle with when we ask God for it. 2 Corinthians 10:4, it says, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God. I don't know if the church is ready even when all hell is breaking loose. Even when there's nothing to stand on. The church can stand for your neighbors. The church can stand for your brothers and sisters. The church can stand for those who are hurting. I'm going to ask the question, can the church return as the advocate of mankind and society instead of being its accuser? Why do we not leave the latter for the enemy? The church must rise out of its state of hunger. I believe we're hungering for money. We're hungering for power. We hunger to be seen. And my brothers and sisters, we don't want to take on the issues anymore. We don't want to take on the issues of man and society. But let the church again be the voice of the poor and the downtrodden. Let the church feel the hunger, the pains of the fatherless and motherless. Let the church be the place of refuge once again for those who are hurting, whose family and friends have died by whatever cause. Let the church be ready to represent man and his clients as God's representative. Christ represented us and is still representing us. He has been the propitiation for our sin. He satisfied all the requirements for sin. Took on himself the agony of pain. Why is it then to find it so hard?